Hi guys, now today we will see about the difference of two vectors in a plane that makes an angle theta to each other. Alright, okay, so just see that difference of two vectors in a plane makes an angle theta with each other. Okay. We will here we will use the same method of just like the sum of two vectors. All right, so accordingly you can see here that now you just see here that one vector be there, you just suppose that vector A, all right, and another vector B. Vector BB there. If it makes an angle theta to each other, we don't have to add to both of the vectors to each. Actually, we have to subtract in each. Okay. Therefore, for subtraction, you just take this vector in its opposite in direction like that. So this one is your vector B, but because this vector is in opposite in direction, okay, so a negative sign will be there. And just take this point just like P. Okay, this one is Q, just suppose this one is Q, so point Q. So how much be this vector, how much be this angle? So this angle be 180 minus theta, because the all angle on this straight line be 180, you just subtract theta, so 180 minus theta be there. And then here we have to find its sum. So for this sum, just draw a line like that. Suppose this one be resultant vector r be the resultant vector. Okay, so if this one be a resultant vector, so accordingly what we have to do, so accordingly here we can see that this one is resultant vector r, and 180 degree minus theta be the angle between vector A and vector B. So use the previous one relation that r vector, so this r vector be how much? This r vector be a square plus b a square plus 2ab cos theta. We have to use this relation because once we have calculated in sum of the two vectors in a plane. Alright, so we will use the same relation. So use previous one. So use previous relation. Okay, and accordingly A square. So A vector A be there. So vector A square, and this one is its magnitude. So vector A square plus vector B A square plus vector A, vector B, and then cos theta. Now here you have to remember about, and you have to be cautious about this angle theta, because your theta is not this theta. Right now your theta has been changed to 180 degree minus theta, because here right now we are going to take difference of the two vectors in that plane. So this one is right now 180 degree minus theta of root. Okay. of root. So your magnitude of resultant R, now you just calculate this one, that a square plus b square plus here is 2ab. Now cos 180 degree minus theta is minus cos theta, because cos 180 minus theta just went to second quadrant, and in second quadrant sine and cosec is positive, so cos will be negative at there. Alright, okay, so this one is minus, so minus cos theta. Alright, therefore after being calculation, your resultant will be like that, that a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta. Okay, so you got it from here. Now in same manner, suppose this one is a equation. Now in same manner, using previous one relation for the sum of the two vectors in that plane, if here I want to find the angle of this resultant, so we need to write that if alpha is the angle, alpha is the angle with the resultant. Okay, so just write down that if resultant makes an angle alpha with a vector a. Okay, therefore then this one is very simple, that just apply the previous concept okay, and now your previous concept is that see here, that this resultant makes an angle alpha. Okay, this one is now making an angle alpha with a vector a. So just apply that tan alpha, and tan alpha is what? Tan alpha is b sin theta divided by a plus b cos theta. Then here b cos cautious about the angle, because your angle is not theta, your angle is 180 degree minus theta, so use always 180 degree minus theta. So this one is the key and concept of for this sum, for this difference. So simple, tan alpha is just write down here that b sin theta, so sin in place of theta 180 degree minus theta divided by a plus b cos theta. So in place of theta you again need to take 180 degree minus theta and then resolve this one. Therefore from here you are seeing that your tan alpha is how much, this one is b sin theta sin, and see this one is 180 minus theta, so sin will not change, and because 180 degree minus theta that goes in second quadrant, right now in second quadrant sin is positive, so this one is sin theta, and then divided by a, and this one is b cos theta. So here cos will not change because there is 180 degree, but 180 minus theta goes to second quadrant, and in second quadrant cos is negative, so this one is minus cos theta. Therefore instead of a plus b, it will change to a minus b cos theta. All right, therefore alpha is very simple, tan inverse b sin theta divided by a minus b cos theta. Got it? So this one is your resultant. That makes an angle alpha with a vector a. So next equation be there. Alright. Okay. Now one more change be there. Here I want to find the angle of this resultant r with a vector b. So how much this will be? Okay. So suppose this resultant makes an angle beta. Alright? Okay. So use same manner. So what here we have to use that just apply the previous concept accordingly. And in that previous concept, what we have to use? See, here we have to see there is two changes here we have to see. And that changes is in first one, in tan alpha, there is b sin theta. So that will change. In second one, because this one is making an angle with vector b, so a is not taking part. So tan alpha instead of b there is a, instead of a there is b, instead of b there is a. That we have to change. So that will be a sin theta divided by b plus a cos theta. So there is change. So we just change it like that. Instead of b there is a, instead of alpha there is beta, instead of a there is b, and instead of b there is a. Alright, like that. This one is same just like the previous one. So you see here that your tan beta, see a sine, again sine 180 minus sine 180 degree minus theta goes into second quadrant. In second quadrant sine is positive, there is no change in sine because there is 180 degree. Alright, okay, so this one is how much? Simple a sine theta. Now in next step b is same, and here because 180 minus theta goes into second quadrant, and in second quadrant cos is negative, so b minus a cos theta, cos will not change, okay, it will become negative. So b minus a cos theta, that means how much be your beta? So your beta, that will be tan inverse. See here, this one is tan inverse a sin theta. Alright, a sin theta divided by b minus a cos theta, and this one is your resultant. Okay, and next equation be there. So this one is the key, this one is very important key, that how you can draw the diagram and how you can find the resultant and the angle with vector a and with vector b, that is alpha and beta, how you can find. Okay, so just keep in mind. All right.